You know, I'm kind of a world famous trombone champ streamer. I still don't know how that happened, but you know, if anyone for some reason wants to interview me for the news about trombone champ and only trombone champ, yeah, that's fine. But I have custom songs, which I knew was going to happen, but I'm glad it's finally here. Thank you to Leafy Boy Koi, I think, is who sent this. And I think it also comes with all the stuff unlocked, which is cool. I can play as Servant of Babby. So spoilers, I guess. But yeah, we're just going to check out these songs. You're going to see, well, you see right here. I'm going to play 600 AD first from Chrono Trigger. I can't believe people have made some of these. It's going to be really cool. But keep in mind, this is going to be 100% VOD mute. This video is going to be a huge fucking pain in the ass. Oh God. Sounds even worse than the other songs in the game. I got this, chat. Time to butcher my favorite songs. That's not in the song. Why is that even there? That's just... That's what I like to call a jape vibrato. That's not there! Okay. This is not going to be good for my voice. If I'm trying to get it healed, this is not how to do it. Some of these are like MIDI recreations, and some are just the actual songs. That's my own horn that V-Dub put on my soundboard that he used his feet on. Okay. You know what? I'll take it. There's also a new feature. There's been some updates since I last played this, including some stats. Someone wanted to know if there's one winged angel. Of course there is. Now we're going to do that, but let's do Wii Shop next and then we'll do one winged angel. Stinky. Mario 3. Oh god, this is more challenging than I expected. I'm like screech laughing. Oh no, why did I choose to play this tonight? I should have waited like another couple days. I'm just trying to put a little stank on it, you know, when you're a pro. When you're a pro, you can do that. That's like when you're an English major. Well, we're gonna get to Walk Like an Egyptian and the Red Vox stuff. But there's some pretty amazing fucking songs on here that have been added, including a Radiohead song, weirdly enough. But we got to do One Winged Angel. Early. We're doing it early. It doesn't sound like the right key. Oh God, there's a custom video for it. Oh, for fuck's sake. It just seemed like... Some of the song just looks like ropey load. I love that it's also Sephiroth with a giant, like, Masamune... Oh, it's the Advent Children version. Yes! The trombone is, like, massive! Oh god, here it is. It's... I'm butchering it so hard. Oh. I saw this performed in a fucking concert hall by an actual orchestra. And now I'm doing this. I'm insulting the memory of that show. And yet the weird thing is there's probably more people in this chat right now than there were at that concert. That's fucking weird. It wasn't the biggest venue. I think it was earlier this year. Was it Carnegie? Oh. Oh. Oh no. Not this part, anything but. Oh. I am so happy they don't fail you out of a level like Guitar Hero. Oh no, oh god. Oh no. Oh, the Advent Children solo. Oh no. No, not this. Is it over? No. Oh no. My wrist hurts. I used to think they were saying Hallelujah, Sephiroth. Sexy frog? No. Do you think Cloud and his gang at any point had to explore the carpal tunnel in the world of Final Fantasy VII? Oh. Boy, I should have probably not played that one so soon. All right, we're gonna do Radiohead now. I like Radiohead. Look at it's just the video. It's a close-up of Tom's face. Like I said, some of these songs are just rips, high quality rips. So VOD will be absolutely destroyed unless the trombone covers up. Nah, it won't. It won't. Rest in peace, VOD. You will be missed. Where's the vibrato? It's either too much or none. Thank you. Well, boy, that last song really, really made this one a cakewalk. Well, that, and it's a cakewalk. Now I know what it's like to be John Radiohead on stage, live, performing for an audience. And then someone in the audience yells, "Play Creep!" And then Ed says, "Ed!" Ed. Well, there's Ed, but he's not saying his own name. Hell of a time to lose a combo. So happy I got to look at Thom Yorke's face, half submerged in a fishbowl. My first impressions are forever tainted. Use left hand to click on keyboard, right hand to move mouse only. Better for the pain. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Someone said there's supposed to be lyrics. Is that true? I don't know if that's true. I'm going to try the bass trombone. Remix 10, Naive Melody. We're no strangers to love. You know the rules. It's trying to recreate the video, too. It's Robo's theme. We're no strangers to love. Look, it's got the lyrics this time. You know the rules, and so do I. Oh, boy. Sound worse than the trombone. It just sounds like an annoying mosquito.
You're too shy to say it. And if you ask me how I'm feeling, don't tell me that you're too blind to see.
Wait, that's not how it goes. I was reading the lyrics, but I didn't know how the melody went. And then I just held the mouse the whole time. I'm sorry to subject my audience to that. V-Dub would never do such a thing. Actually struggling with this more than I did One Winged Angel. It's funny because someone said use the your left hand to hit the space bar instead of clicking with the mouse. And that's fine, but that's reverse how I play guitar. I fret with my left hand and I strum with my right hand. So it throws, it's weirdly like throwing me off rhythmically, even though I'm not really some would say what rhythm, and you'd be right. Holy fuck, this is horrendous. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna fool around, cause I do. And my microphone has delay on it too, so that's extra cool for a thing like this. Please no more. This high quality YouTuber bait has worked on me. Not the first time, it won't be the last time. Vinny, with maps that have to have many fast taps, try using two fingers on different keys to alternate your presses between each finger. I mean, that makes sense if you want to, like, you know, get good. I'm really curious to see how the Red Vox songs translated, but we'll do one and then the other. I like how this one's genre is clown rock. We'll get to Vomit in the Ball Pit. Oh, actually, let me change the sound. Oh boy. Let me change the sound. Muted. Let's try Gassy. You know what? Let me ruin my song more than I already have in the recording process. I bet people hearing this for the first time are gonna be like, nope. Did they remove the vocals? Why are we doing it like that? What if I told you I had a vision that this would happen when I wrote the song? It's like a wet, clammy fart. What if I told you I wrote this song specifically for farting in Red Vox music, trombone? I don't know what I just said. Someone said Red Vox more like Brown Vox. man. Well, I will never play that song live if we ever do live shows. I just can't after this. No, I will. I like that one. Walk Like an Egyptian. Oh my God. Wait. JoJo. Yeah, okay. Okay. Fart Like an Egyptian? What? I think it's kind of funny that there are people who actually like are pros at this game by now, who like have advanced techniques to get like the highest scores. Because you can play this like a legitimate rhythm game if you want to. I mean, I've been trying the whole time, and it is kind of fun. And some people have made like, you know, like what, like kazoos that feed into the game. Probably other instruments too. I bet people have played this with their fucking feet, their disgusting feet, like mildewy, gross. Cut them off. I can't believe this is real. I don't even know if I'm alive doing this. Up until this point, it's just like farts and bars. And I'm like in some weird meditative state, pondering my fucking mortality. No. How can DMCA claim this? Oh, they will find a way to make money, but you know what the best part is? This video will have so many different DMCA claimed songs, no one will make money. JoJo uses that song in the credits. Oh man, we're getting maximum effort recreation of the AHA video. Yeah. It does bring me great satisfaction that the record labels are going to be claiming literal farts. Oh, there we go. Now we got the pro gameplay. Oh man, look at that. Best part. What is happening in this video? Like, I remember, in chat, I'm going to date myself a little bit here, you know, because you are your own best company. But I remember watching this video on MTV when it was still relatively new. Like, that's one of my earliest memories as a child. That and fucking Guns N' Roses, Paradise City. Uh-huh. Take on me. When was this? What year was this? Like 86, I'm going to guess. 85. So that's the year I was born. So MTV would play that. Peter Gabriel, Sledgehammer. And, you know. Then Guns N' Roses constantly. But yeah. That and also Dire Straits. The fucking 3D models. I was like, how does that work? That's amazing. Hey, Paps. Perfect. You know, hearing this again reminds me of that one parade theme from Final Fantasy VII. This right here. Like, why am I even getting, like, a B on that? That was fucking terrible. Ugh. I want to hear some more sounds. Someone said, why do you look like Ethan Mars from Heavy Rain? What are you, your new chat member? You don't know. I had my face reconstructed surgically to look like Ethan from Heavy Rain. How do you not know this, Bev? Oh God, I don't know if I can do roundabout. I'll try it. What the fuck is this? Oh, Rhythm Heaven. I've been, you know, people have asked me to play Rhythm Heaven and lots of other games that are rhythm-based. And, you know, this is fun. I like that this is making the chat laugh and everything. I gotta be honest, aside from like Guitar Hero and Rocksmith, I'm not the biggest rhythm guy. I mean, my own rhythm in music is up like debate, of course, but I mean, just I don't love rhythm games all that much. They're fine. I know they're fun. I know they're fun and wacky, and I like watching other people play them. I just don't want to be the one to play them. Including a lot of video footage in this one. By the way, this entire pack was like 800 megabytes. Now I see why. Oh my God, rhythm changes. Every music. I'm assuming this is a medley of all the game's music or something, because it is all music. I mean, I know some of this stuff from various things, like just osmosis. Like that in particular. Oh my God, there's more. I know this song. I don't know why I know this song. Okay. Yeah, fooled me for a minute. I wanna do that Talking Heads one. I'll try it muted. Muted seems good for the Talking Heads one. Live from the concert film, Stop Making Sense. Oh, we're doing the concert version. This is a very simple song. I'm wondering how this is gonna work out. And you may find yourself living in a shotgun shack. Oh, they're going to play the actual Stop Making Sense video? Oh, we get to see David Byrne dance with a lamp. Stop Making Sense is my favorite concert film. But I mean, what would you expect otherwise? I do like Live from Pompeii, and I like the Zeppelin DVD, but this one is just endlessly rewatchable. I watch it every couple years. I love it. You play that keyboard, Jerry. Sorry, David. I don't think this song needs a trombone accompaniment. I really don't. I mean, you know, aside from the funnies, we also get to share some good music together, which in and of itself is rewarding, you know, but then you have this fucking trombone over it. I wonder how many people know that that fucking song that keeps getting sampled is actually written by Tina and Chris France, the drummer. The Tom Tom Club, yeah. What song is it? Oh, God. What Genius of Love. I don't even, I'm hearing another song right now, so I can't actually, like, tell you how it goes. But it just is endlessly replayed in so many other songs. You know how you know you're a good bassist? If you play bass on this song. Because it means that you're fighting boredom. I mean, I love the bass line. Also, Tina's playing guitar on this one. I think the bass line is just like canned for the song, for the live one. The mark of a good drummer and bassist, I feel, are those that don't overplay for relatively simple songs and just let the song be what it is. There are probably a number of people in chat that would disagree and be like, oh, you could spice this. You could give it the old spice. But no, I like a nice simple song. I like Complex, too. I fucking love the Mars Volta, but, you know. Video's not synced. Do it, David. You know you want that lamp. Thank you.
Yeah, there you got it.
This is also the concert where he wears the big suit. So yes, I'd recommend watching the whole thing. I'm biased though. Some say that Steve Carell got the idea for his famous line, "I love lamp," whilst watching this. I just made that up. The fucking genius of Love Song. I want you to hear it. So the drummer and the bassist of Talking Heads are married. That's Tina and Chris. And they wrote a song under a band's name a year after this, I think, called Tom Tom. Well, actually, no, during this. They played it for this show. Genius of Love. This one. It's, you can't escape this song. It's crazy how many people have sampled this song. Good. But they play it during Stop Making Sense. So it's just kind of wacky that the rhythm section of Talking Heads also ended up with a giant hit. Very, very good band. All right. Fabulous Secret Powers. What the fuck is this? Don't Stop Me Now, huh? Big Shot. Oh, that's, I thought that was Big Shot by Billy Joel. Instead, it is Big Shot by Toby Fox. Yeah, there's a full song here. It's funny because I thought when I first watched the show, I was like, did they just write like a little part of a song just to fuck with the audience? I was like, that's totally in line with what these creators are capable of. I mean, I'm not doing it any justice, but I like the song. God. Chad, save your souls for when the part happens. And then unleash them together. Hold. Hold. Now! Cock Dick Solin. I mean, that sounded like shit as an accompaniment, but it is a very good song.
All right, here's what you're going to do. You're going to use this song. That's actually a really good song as your title theme. But you're not going to use all of it. You're only going to use about 8 seconds of it, and then you're going to cut it real short. Now, you're going to be happy with that.
I think farts would be good for All-Star. There he is. Shrimp. Petition to place the singer of Smash Mouth with farts. I was going to say, I do not deserve anything over a C. Vinny, my girlfriend saw what I was watching, listening to, and the expression of disgust implies she's going to break up with me. Thank you. Oh, well, you're welcome, chat member. I'm just going to stick with the stuff that I know. And then if I have a little time at the end, I'll do the stuff I don't know. Hell yeah. It's red and red, white, and blue. Look at Kenny Loggins trying to be cool. I got to be honest. I just can't find a guy cool who's named after what sounds like a turd. Like, I'm pretty sure last week I dropped the Kenny Loggins off at the pool. I mean, I love the dude's music, but... maybe a stage name like Kenny Slade or like Ken Fuck. There was that famous Val Kilmer scene. Oh God, I'm out of breath. That hasn't happened at all today yet. Like, why is he in bed singing this high energy song? Like, what the fuck is this video? How do you hit those high notes while you're laying on your back in a comfy bed wearing like whatever frilly outfit? Like, dude, I'm pretty sure what's his name lost his fucking career over something like this. What's his name? I can't think of his name. The rock guy who did the fucking thing. Billy Squire. Yeah, with Rock Me Tonight. like Rock Me Tonight was the end of that man's career. No one thought he was cool after that video. And Kenny Loggins somehow got cooler after this video. What the fuck? It's the Jets, isn't it? It's 0% Kenny Loggins and 100% Jets. Man, Mighty Wings is better. Stall warning. We're gonna do Don't Stop Me Now, but before I do that, I can't think of a better instrument to do Vomit in the Ball Pith. Hey, yes, the Vomit in the Ball Pith. I can't think of a better instrument to do Vomit in the Ball Pit with than fart trumpet. Here we go. Excellent. Very good. Ha 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 ha! song is mixed a little low. It's been a couple like this. I was dreading this part. Oh God. It's just a symphony of farts. Someone in chat said, I caught it from the corner of my eye. Are you proud of the choices you've made in your life to lead you to this point? I can't answer that other than yes and no. Just like as an honest answer. I added that little spice. I don't know who made this, but I'm going to fucking find you. No, thank you for putting my songs in this game. I appreciate it. Let's see. What other stuff do I know for sure? Roundabout, I know, obviously. In the end, yeah, sure. Linkin Park, fine. Oh yeah, okay. I'm gonna do a hip-hop verse. Well, styled verse, I guess. With a fucking trombone that sounds like farts. Fucking Half-Life 2? It's like the DJ. Yeah. It didn't even matter. Yes, B. Ah, okay. Dragonborn. God. I want to just go back to regular trombone. Do you know Fabulous Secret Power? It's He-Man singing four non. Oh, that's what that is? Yeah, we can do that then. I know that. That's the memes. You know the memes. Okay. Yep. There's some fucking song from the 90s about God. For some reason, this reminds me of that. I don't know. I don't know, chat. I don't know. That was like an inside thought that I just figured, nah, I'll just say it. Who sings it? It was a one-hit wonder from the 90s. Yeah. The artist is four. This is four non-blondes. What if God was one of us? No, I don't think so. Maybe. Maybe it's... Tell me all your thoughts on God. No, maybe I'm just thinking of this song. And it's just because it's faster. It sounds different. I'm not sure. We'll do Dragonborn. I mean, it's losing its comedic value as always. I mean, especially if you're starting with farts. Like, where do you go from farts? All right, time to start up another Skyrim playthrough.
Yeah.
There we go. This is the perfect trombone champ level for me. Does it end? Oh, oops. Actual impossible note. Like we just got trolled by this song. Okay. Someone said in chat, this was so inspiring, I will now name my beat red colored child Dovahkiin. But I read that real quick before it scrolled up. As I will now beat my reed to Dovahkiin. And I was like, wow, that's a new one. I've never heard that one before. Shit. Get ready for like mega failure on this song. Mr. Fahrenheit, traveling at the speed of light, gonna make a supersonic man out of you. Just maximum disrespect to Freddy by playing this with farts. Thank you. I tried to laugh in time. But again, delay on the microphone. Once again, I've entered some sort of like weird fugue state. I feel like Freddie wrote this just to like troll people that would cover Queen songs. Just because it's such a fucking vocal workout. Like, holy fuck. His voice is all over. With somebody to love too. I mean, that's a lot of Queen. Freddie was just, he just had not just good range and good control, but good expression, good power. Like, the dude had everything in a singer that you could want. And he was also good in like a lower register, a higher register, mid. Joel's reacting to your attempted impersonation of his voice. I'm fucked. All right. Well, I guess we got to do Roundabout. Let that be the finale. Where is it? Did I lose it? Down further? Chat, why don't I see the roundabout? That's really weird. I don't know what happened there. My brain just fucking died. All right, let's check it out. Continued, I know. Said it. It's such a good song, though. I remember this being super overplayed on the classic rock radio station in New York City. So I knew it before the JoJo's. I'm cool.
Yeah.
It's Rick Wakeman. God. It just, yeah, I mean, what are we, like, one third of the way through the song? One eighth? Yes writes some really fucking long songs. Again, can't even play that note. I don't know why that's like the perfect combination of notes to make me laugh. How long until Stairway to Heaven and Echoes by Floyd are in this? All 22 minutes of Echoes. Oh yeah, okay, we'll just do that. Sounds like a Vespa. It's like a fucking, like a tiny motorized bicycle. It is now over. Oh, I've grown so old playing through that. Oh, all right. Remember this? It's new. We haven't seen it. I was literally asked about the baboons during the interview. It was like, what did you think about the baboon storyline? I'm like, wow, what a fucking life this is. Okay, I already have this because the file unlocked all this stuff. The rings are lit. The toot vessel is finally fully charged. Just one final awakening awaits thee. I'm certain that the toot vessel can be further awakened. Like, I don't already have carpal tunnel after this game, and now I have to click 100 times in a row.
Permanent wrist damage.
The toot vessel is exhausted. Oh. What do I do with this key? Oh. I never beat the main game, no. Gotta get cards. Well, I remember this. All right, I remember now. Hey, hello there. If you wish, I shall now share the full truth of the trombone champ. An answer worthy of the trombone champ. Well, let's get started. In the ancient days, the first lords created music. At that time, things were in harmony, but a natural discordance began to arise within the music. There were those who sought to destroy the harmony. For each positive note, there was a negative. Bass begat treble. Mozart begat tritone. You can stop now. Yes, stop. Okay, goodbye. Well, that will forever be the end of the game. Cool. However, bonus segment, just because, I don't know, something weird came my way, I'd like to tell you about before we take a quick break. The game is cool, and I'll probably return to it if there is enough funny songs. Thank you, Leaf Friend, for making this pack. If anyone has, in the future, let's say in another 2 months, there's like another series of songs that might be fun and entertaining, I would probably play it again with a curated pack of like, 15 songs or so. And please feed my ego, make more Red Vox. I mean, so listen, chat, before we move on to the next thing, rather, before we take a break, I got an email from someone. Hey, Vinny, to keep things short, I got attacked by an uncharacteristically aggressive dog and was laid up in the hospital. Somewhere in between guzzling the rabies vaccine and hefty doses of morphine, though, I came up with what could arguably refer to colloquially as some music. No, just music, no song, no lyrics. So basically, it's rabies music. Best with earphones. I left the audio mixing alone after the fact, even though it's a little stinky. So I haven't heard this, and I figured, fuck it, let me just do this live. This is like uncharacteristic of me, because then, you know, people are going to send me thousands of songs, but I just want to hear rabies music. This one's called Sunny Putrefaction. This is by someone who calls themselves Rhyme Lee. You're fucking lucky you're alive, by the way, chat member. I mean, it is similar to Mr. Blue Sky. Starting to hear the rabies a little bit. Yeah, best snare I've ever heard. You know what? Someone's gonna fuck to this and it's gonna become a huge Reddit thread in like 5 years. Our bet. Boy, you composed and arranged a full-ass fucking song while you had rabies and morphine coursing through your veins. All right. I'm just going to skip ahead a little bit because it's like 5 minutes. All right, you get the idea. It's not bad. Then there's Rainy Putrefaction. This is the other rabies song. Complete with storm. Oh, okay. It's the same. It's like when you're in a video game and it starts raining and the music like dampens. Can we have a link? I don't know if this is uploaded online. Listen, if the rabies chat member wishes to upload this somewhere on the internet and then let everyone know, you know, go for it. But at the moment, it was just sent to me. There's also, you know, the matter of, is chat member telling the truth? Possibly. But it's just a pretty, you know, it's an email. Could be fake rabies. I don't know. Someone said, I trust John Rabies. Their chat name, Colostomy Bagel. So, you got at least the support of Colostomy Bagel, chat member. Someone said, I mean, I don't know why anyone would lie about that. Fair, but chat member, the internet is home to many, many bizarre lies. Every day, all the time. I'll give you an example of one. you know, listen, Rabies Chat member, I'm going to go ahead and say that this is pleasant music. Very good, like, video game music. This version I like a little bit better. It sounds like a cool theme for an Earthbound-esque game. And I like that. I think it's got, yeah, a little Stardew Valley. I think it's pretty cool. It's this is officially I Am Scared of Water music. And you know what's funny? We're like kind of making light of rabies a little bit, but rabies is one of the most terrifying things I've ever read about. I know we have treatment for it, and if you catch it quick, you know, you'll be all right. But holy fuck, rabies is absolutely horrendous as a concept. So, you know, if this is the sound of this chat member thrashing against the rabies, then I approve. I don't know why I said it like that. It's a very musical stream day. Well, thank you, Rabies chat member. You have the support of Colostomy Bagel once again. I'd like to point that out. And I'm glad you're alive. I hope, you know, hope everything goes well for you. And thank you for sharing your tunes. Now, listen, chat member, not just one chat member, but all chat members. If you're going to send me songs and be like, Vinny, you know, I my leg broke. This is broken leg music. Or like, you know, Vinny, I was on a ventilator and I wrote some music on my laptop. Here's my SoundCloud. Vinny, this is my cock break music. Can you play my cock injured music, please, on your stream? I think the chat members will like it. I'm not gonna play it. Be right back.